Okay, game three. I choose to play first. My hand is terrible. Like, terribly terrible. Oh, goodness. What do? I really don't want to keep. Alright, I will. I mean, it's just a good mix of blue and green lands, blue and green spells. It doesn't have particularly strong synergy together, but if I draw a green card that costs 2 mana, it's a great hand because I can make a 3-3 and just build it up. And even if I just draw a couple lands, it's a unexciting but fine hand. So I'm just going to hope that it works out. That's a good draw, as long as I hit a land next. Because if I hit a land next turn, I can make a 3-3 Revenant Hunter and probably take over the game with it. Time to feed and bounce, or pump spell, I mean. Yep, not drawing a land there's pretty terrible for me, but I still have time. As long as my opponent doesn't go too crazy. I feel like I'm going to lose to one of those 1-4 Acolytes that makes mana. He's going to play that. He's going to make a lot of mana real fast. It's going to be lights out. Here's the father. Let's see what happens. Goodness, Sedge Scorpion. Well, we knew he just drew that, so. Did not have a land, so has to top deck a land next turn. Seems good for me. Not going to trade a 3-3 with a Scorpion. So. That's just something I refuse to do. Mountain seems like a good draw for my opponent. Yeah, Sealock Monster is not good. I bash. Hopefully some kind of trades happen where I can play a pump spell to destroy the Acolyte. Wouldn't even mind just my creatures dying so I can eventually cast Nemesis of Mortals. Would not mind a 5/5 creature at this point in the game. Especially at the point in which my opponent's Death Touch creature dies and then I put a 5/5 into play. It's like quite a bit stronger than any other thing that could happen. Well, I'm much happier to have a Breaching Hippocamp here than a Benthic Giant, just because I can cast it. Certainly don't hate just putting big creatures into play. Well, medium big. Yep, I actually thought my opponent would cast that card. Not sure why. Let's go to camp. Hippocamp. Gaining a life here. I have an interesting play that I'm considering. I want to cast Savage Surge on Breaching Hippocamp, cast Time to Feed on Hippocamp and the Acolyte, and then just attack with everything. Because if he trades with the Hippocamp, that's fine. If he blocks my Satyr Hedonist, he's going to go to one life. So both of those plays seem good. My problem is I can't use Time to Feed to do anything unless I put the Mortals in play first, in which case I'm letting my opponent untap with the Acolyte to make 3 mana when I know his hand is all spells. Yeah, I'm just going to do the play that I want to do. Well, I could just Savage Surge the Chimera, and then he goes to 2 no matter what. I don't kill the Vulping Goliath, though. Let me think here about the merits of those. Jeez. Put my opponent to 2 life. And kill his mana. Killing the mana is, like, far less impressive than... I mean, I could just... No. I want to cast Time to Feed this turn. My problem is my opponent's just going to cast an Essie and Asp, and then I can't win. So... Man, this is a really tough decision. Yeah, here's what I'm gonna do. I'm going to cast this card, and I'm going to cast the Time to Feed. Boom, boom. I go up to 25, I attack with everything. I'm going to kill your Vulping Goliath, or you're going to go to one life. Pick your poison. I can settle in for a late game with 2 big monsters in my hand. And killing the Goliath is great. Putting my opponent to 1 life seems great as well. Alright, he chooses to keep the Goliath in play. Now he's at 1 and I have a flyer, so priority number 1 for him is to answer the Chimera. If he doesn't do that, he is going to die. Anger the Gods, jeez. That's a powerful spell. Okay, 1, 2. And that's a really bad card to draw. Ho! I can enchant my opponent's land and make it an island. Alright, I like that play. Somehow my opponent might just attack me and die. Alright. I take it all. I go to 10. And my creature in my hand costs 4 mana, so if I draw a forest in my top 2, I actually have quite a good play. Yep, let's do this. Draw a card. And I attack you. Please have no battle trick. My opponent said, thank you, in the chat. Makes me think he's going to kill me with some splash card in his hand. No, he had to chump block, so that's good. I do like it when my opponents chump block. Just hope he doesn't attack with the Vulpian Goliath, because it almost guarantees that I have to chump block or I'm going to die. You know, I mean, it only goes up to a 9 power, but if he has anything to increase power and I don't block, I just lose on the spot. So, and it's highly unlikely that my opponent would be bluffing in a situation like that. Never even noticed the interaction between Nylea's presence and Sealock Monster. I actually kind of like it. Just makes my creature a 5/5 for 5 with no handicap whatsoever. I think I played this game well. I did get blown out, but there was no possible way I could have predicted my opponent would cast Anger the Gods, so it's like kind of a wash. Ooh, that is a very, very good card. I will pass the turn. If my opponent does nothing, I'm going to monstrosity one of my creatures. If he does something, I'm going to cast Dissolve. Also, my opponent only has one card in his hand, so opponent have one card in his hand and I have a hard counter. Seems like a fine situation for me. Clearly gonna monstrosity here. I monstrosity the monster first because I'm gonna attack with it. He's gonna block with the Sedge Scorpion. Then next turn I monstrosity the Nemesis of Mortals. And I actually have a 10-10 against an 8-7 and he has to chump block. So if I do it any other way, like if I monstrosity the Nemesis or whatever. Goodness, what is this? Boulder Fall. Ugh. Well, that's a good draw. I mean, I'll allow it. He's at one life and I just drew an unblockable creature with counterspell backup, so. Seems good. Chump block. That's fine. I go to 4 or 5 or whatever. And then I counter whatever your card is and I attack you for unblockable. And that's game, boys.